So Prabhjot and I have been working together for almost 2 decades now. This project is in quite a few ways reflecting of our own process. In many ways, that's how our collaboration has been working. You can say we are on either end of a seesaw and making music together, where we are sometimes together, sometimes apart, because we live across continents. He lives in India, I live here. But when things are not all pandemic, we usually travel to each other when a larger project is happening. And we've done a lot of projects together. We love working in the public art space. We enjoy it when other people come together to become part of that. And which is why we create these interactive, kinetic kind of works that get people together, and so that art becomes an experience for everybody to enjoy, because it's really those little joys that inform our lives, and it's nice to savor them as you go. This work is called Jugalbandi in the gardens. So Jugalbandi is an Indian musical concept where two musicians of different genres or different schools, they come together on a formal stage and they perform simultaneously. They come together at that time and they both play to the same raga, which is the same symphony, but it's not pre-planned, it's completely impromptu. And they create, they weave their notes as they go. And it's like a musical conversation. It's like jamming, but it's musicians who've, you know, reached a certain height of their career who are coming and doing it. So it's of a different quality. And we thought when we were creating the work was that, you know, our world is so split up into binaries at the moment. You know, any topic that comes up, any issue that comes up, there seems to be these two warring sides and who never get to have a conversation and, you know, find out that if they did get together, there'd be a solution. You know, you'd be playing music. So this work kind of lets you do that, you know. It brings together people who may not agree with each other or who may be from different thought processes, but they come together at the same time and converse and make a good thing together. So the seesaw itself is made of macrocarpa wood, which is hard wood. We've tried to keep it quite clean, so the lines are really clean. So it's just a triangle and a rectangle on top. And then we have the bells, of course, because they were sort of the focus of the piece, you know, because that's what you play. So this is like an example of what it will go on to. So, because when we put this bell on top of the seesaw, the person riding the seesaw can reach up their hand and make music with it from one side. That's the intention. It's so satisfying to see the work once it's done, and for when people do become part of it as well. Because even during the creation, we always think of the people who will become part of it and set it to motion. So I think that is probably the most fun element of this work, that it becomes a work almost when there are two participants in it and they set it in motion. So, you know, when they are playing the bells, there's movement, there's a tactile element to it, there is an oral quality to it, and it is completely immersive in the time, because you want to be properly sitting on your seesaw, you're not really thinking of other things then. And it allows you to be in that zone, creates a certain zone where you can just surrender to making music and forgetting everything else for that particular period of time.